to play with the young and beautiful creatures of the underworld. The most beautiful of all these was the woman I loved, Satine, a courtesan. She sold her love to men. They called her the Sparkling Diamond, and she was the star of the Moulin Rouge. Devoted to the act, but has always longed to be a real actress in a real play. I first came to Paris 1 year ago. It was 1899, the summer of love. I knew nothing of the Moulin Rouge, Harold Zidler, or Satine. The world had been swept up by a Bohemian revolution, and I had traveled from London to be a part of it. Yes, I have come to live a penniless existence, to write about truth, beauty, freedom, and above all things, love. But by a stroke of luck, I came upon a group of Bohemian playwrights. They discovered my talent and wanted me to be a writer for a modern play called Spectacular Spectacle. We needed someone like Zidla to finance the play, so we had she planned. I would show Satine my talent in writing, and she convinced Zidla to go through with the play. So we snuck into the Moulin Rouge that night with scheme in mind.
Welcome to the Moulin Rouge!
Boys.
Really? Totally alone?
Don't talk to me, Zidler! And there comes a time when I ask me to lie. And there comes a time when I have bought in prior things. When there's no eyes and private eyes. Where's the Joker, Harold? Where is he? Turn me around, I want to see!
That's the one.
Ooh, so we can best on a pieta. This type, smile with a flower, very provoking, but small to be tempted.
As the performance ended, Christian went inside the elephant room to convince Madame Satine to invest in their play. The Duke was talking with Harold Zidler and was making their way into the elephant room. Christian, the writer, never knew that the room was intended for something else with the Duke. As Christian made himself comfortable, Satine was busy being dressed up. She knows how important the Duke is for their play, and she knows what she must do. Looking like a smoldering temptress, she enters the room.
Thank you.
Yes, was indeed in love with Satine, and Satine felt the same way too. In each day of the rehearsal, their bond became stronger and stronger,
And soon enough, the fiery touch of love came upon them as their relationship became more intimate. The only thing that poses a threat to their relationship is the powerful Duke and the inevitable day of the wedding. Blinded by passion, they ignored this, and everything was going along smoothly until one fatal day. And so, Harold Zidler went to find Satine.
Satine, come here.
And he told her everything. That the Duke knows and what the Duke will do if he happens to catch Satine and Christian together. Harold Zidler, convincing as ever, told the fragile Satine that what must be done in order to keep both her dream and Moulin Rouge afloat. Break up with Christian as soon as possible and visit the Duke afterwards to make amends.
You still have to marry the
Sir, that is.
woman exists, I promise you. I see. Don't worry. I will still invest in you, stupid thing. If you look at me in the eyes right now and tell me the truth, do you love me or not?
With the depth of his love, Christian's mind was slowly spiraling down into darkness. And with every ounce of sanity he had left, He wrote the story of his life, the Moulin Rouge, and how the love of his life died by his own hands. After finishing his story, there was only one thing left to do.
Presenting the cast of the Moulin Rouge. Now our tag dancers. To be followed by our gentleman. And our main cast, James Aaron Pimentel as Hayao Tudler, James Russell as the Duke, Kevin Papuba as our Christian, and Miss Christiana Maria Nova as our brother and sister. Once again, the Moulin Rouge. Thank you and have a good day.